Welcome back. It's been 3 days since I last saw you, and the painting has had time to dry. What we have here is what we call an underpainting. And in any underpainting, we want to make the painting look as good as we possibly can. And we're always trying to make it look perfect, but it doesn't happen like that. In fact, I've only been able to do this once, and that was on a painting that was this big. But so now here we are. I've had time to think about this, and I'm going to make some changes on this. I'm trying to make the corrections. Many times people feel like if they don't get it right the first time, they don't know how to do it. Well, I don't ever get it right the first time. I always have to make adjustments. And if you have to make adjustments, then you're doing it with the way I'm doing it. So there's nothing wrong with that. So now I'm going to lay out my colors, and we're going to get started. Oil paint is beautiful, and it allows you to make lots of mistakes. It is intended to be painted in layers. So here we are on the second layer, and we're going to make the changes that I've decided that this painting needs. The primary change is that we need more contrast up in here. The contrast here is much too weak. All this green looks a lot like the same green to me, and I don't want that to happen. I want this to be a little more varied. So the first thing I'm going to do is change that green. And also, compositionally, as I drew this, I realized that I have too much activity on this edge. I want to have something to balance this activity, and so I have to emphasize this composition on this side now. And one of the things I'm going to do to make that happen is I'm going to make this dark here. There's a line here. I'm going to make that line stronger so that the activity on this side of the composition will be as interesting as the activity over here. So this is the beginning. Now this greater contrast should bring up the other colors as well. Trying to make this into a subtle blend from one side to the other. Now many people feel that if you have the light coming from over here, we can't have the dark there. Well, it turns out that that happens to be a really handy device. It makes the painting much more three-dimensional to have the light, the side that has the light have the most dark, so that the light on this part of the onion goes against the dark. That gives it more three dimension. Now, I don't want a sharp edge back in here because that creates another little difficulty compositionally, so I want to soften that edge up too. And I'm going to do that by mixing some of the same color green that I used elsewhere. And I'm going to, so that this no longer creates an arrow pointing at anything. Here I don't want it quite so soft, so I'll have that a little sharper. Over here this is still fairly soft. So now you can see how the composition has changed just by the addition of this dark. We also have some other corrections to make, and the one that's the most interesting, and you probably all noticed this already, but the holes in the urchins are too low. So I have to put new holes in the urchin, which means that I have to rematch this color and wipe this out on both of these. Okay, so you see, I've made a mistake and I've made a correction. This is what painting is about, fixing your mistakes. Sometimes it's important just to go ahead and make a mistake, just to get it on the canvas, get past that awkward place in the beginning of each painting when you don't know what you're doing. When you make a mistake, you know what you don't want to do, at least, which is a step in the right direction. Okay, you see that? I'm picking up the old color, and I have to change the thickness of this paint. Now, I should mention that we want to work from thin to fat. This is an important, you probably read about this someplace before. Thin to fat is a way of thinking about the layers of paint. The first layer that you put down is thin, which means that it has only the turpentine or the thinner added to it. The second layer has oil added to it, not pure oil. I like to use half linseed and half thinner for my next layer, and this prevents cracking in the future. So the first layer is considered thin, turpentine only, thinner only as a medium. Second layer is fatter, linseed oil, and thinner together. And then the third layer, should you go to a third layer, includes varnish. Now there's some other things in this painting that have to be fixed. One of which is that we have a bunch of colors which do not relate to each other. They're all unique in their own position. And the most unique of these colors is this red-violet. So I want to include this red-violet elsewhere in the painting, otherwise it looks like it's just sort of isolated there. And one of the places I've decided that I'm going to include it is in the shadow side of this carrot. Now this is totally unnatural. This is not what's happening. But the painting is more important than the real thing. The painting has to make sense before anything else makes sense. All right, now, this purple over here will now relate itself better overall. Okay, these are little subtle touches that will make a world of difference in the final analysis. We have other things to relate this painting. And this actually is in the still life. There is a reflection of this carrot on this blue cup. So I want to include that also. So I'm going to take a little of my orange, the orange I used for the carrot, very subtle. So a few of these little touches in here will synchronize the colors. Now I'm going to do this over here in the urchin too. I think that it could benefit from a little harmony. Okay, so we're relating the colors within their own context.